Out in Tucson, just underway, about 9 seconds underway, Georgetown and UNC Charlotte are playing out at the McHale Center, and Bob Carpenter and Billy Packer are courtside. Enjoy the game, and we'll get you back to your games after this.
Each team has missed on their first possession. That's Victor Page for Georgetown. He couldn't knock down the left-hander. And the offensive rebound for Boubacar Howe. And that's how the scoring gets started here in Tucson today.
Bob, a wild start. Georgetown had an easy layup to score. Boubacar Howe had the shot blocked. And then Victor Page, a leading scorer in the Big East, gives up one that was an absolute easy shot to make on the layup.
Georgetown 20-9, 11-7 in the Big East in the regular season. They finished with a flourish. This is the huge guy at the offensive end for UNC Charlotte, Alexander Kuhl. And the German gets a second chance. He's not the prettiest thing in terms of finesse, but he can be tough to deal with from a physical standpoint.
Jahadi White and Kuhl really have a lot of power in there. You're looking at two guys right up around 280 pounds going against each other. Which guy gets into foul trouble first? That looks like that's going to be the score.
This is a sub-regional, features a lot of great individual talent. Tim Duncan is here. Van Horn is here from Wake and Utah, respectively. Stanford, Oklahoma, the late game tonight. And this expected to be a very good matchup of number 7, NC Charlotte, and number 10, Georgetown. At the line, Jahidi White. Nice rotation, gets it down. That looked a lot better than a 48% shooter than Jahidi is. They shoot 59 as a team. And of course, Georgetown, sometimes their success depends on if they can hit the basket at all. They play great pressure defense, but sometimes the offense disappears. But early here, they're on top 4-2.
Well, and of course, if you make your free throws, and if you're shooting under 50%, that's not often, you give yourself an opportunity to get into a press situation, as they did right there, handled well by Colson.
Sean Colson handles the point for NC Charlotte, a junior out of Philly.
2-3 zone now by Georgetown, matching up.
That's Versal Shaw, late insertion into the lineup. They call him versatility because he can do so many different things, and a big basket early. Yaya Ja, the most improved player in the Big East. He is a 10-rebound-per-game guy. And, of course, Victor Page led the Big East in scoring at 23 points a game. Kuhl takes it right away, and Versal Shaw can knock it down. There's Kuhl again, and with a man on his back, he fails to knock it down, but does draw the foul. UNC Charlotte, 21-8 out of Conference USA. DeMarco Johnson, the 6'8 junior, is their go-to guy. And Sean Colson was second-team all-conference with 6 assists per game. And there's Melvin Watkins. He was an outstanding player, Billy, on their 1977 Final Four team.
Absolutely, brought in by Bill Foster. Part of what turned everything around in a hurry for UNC Charlotte. As you said, they went to the Final Four in the NIT championship game. The very next year came back and went to the Final Four in Atlanta, losing both games down there, but doing nothing to take away from the brilliant job that Bill Foster did, and then to put together that team in a hurry. And of course, Melvin has been with UNC Charlotte ever since as a assistant coach, now the head man.
From the corner, it's short for Victor Page, who came into this NCAA in a bit of a shooting slump out of that Big East tournament. DeMarco Johnson with the charge. It's going back the other way.
And Kuhl has been hit in the face as well, so I don't know if he got poked in the eye or what the problem was, but it looks like he's going to be all right to stay out there.
John Thompson, as opposed to Melvin Watkins, who's in his first year, this is year number 25 for John, 15th consecutive NCAA, with the likes of Allen Iverson and Othella Harrington. They went to the Final Eight last year before UMass and Camby and company got it. We're 2-10 in. This is Joseph Tuomu running the point for John Thompson. Yaya Ja with the jumper. It's well off to the right side. And the rebound for Versal Shaw of the 49ers.
John's club not getting any offensive rhythm right now, and that has been their problem all year long. Let's see if they get Page the ball the next time down the floor to get him started.
Charlotte will keep it after the miss by Sean Colson.
You know, there's some people that probably say, well, you know, Bill Foster isn't the guy that coached that team with Melvin Watkins and started out with Cornbread Maxwell. No, he's the guy that recruited them. Lee Rose is the fella that then took them to the Final Four and did an outstanding job. with fellas that Bill Foster started the program there in Division I and did the preliminary recruiting.
Shanderick Downs with the dump down to Cool. That's Jahidi White trying to keep him away from the basket. What a matchup that is. And there's Versal Shaw again. He's only averaging 4 a game, and he's got that many already.
One of the things that UNC Charlotte does very well, and you noticed this yesterday in practice, they all catch the ball extremely well.
Yaya Ja with a great first step to the basket.
And that's where Ja wants to be, as opposed to that jumper we saw the last time down on the floor. He's about a 10-foot from the basket type player, both from a rebounding standpoint, defensive standpoint, and where he wants to touch the ball offensively.
That's Shaw for Cool at the high post. Colson had a chance, but Victor Page closed on him very quickly. Flashing along the baseline was Downs. Instead, they go in to the go-to guy, DeMarco Johnson. Charlotte out of Conference USA, 2-6 against the NCAA this year. Their wins came against Marquette and against Louisville in the Conference USA tournament.
It looks like Downs has been cut right above the eye, and he's going to have to sit down for a second. There's some blood there, so now we see the first substitutions for both clubs. Downs going to sit down. Howard, who'd normally be a starter, is going to come in. That gives him a little more shooting power there, but makes the team extremely smaller.
Roderick Carr, normally a starter, outstanding free throw shooter. We'll see him later if it's a close game. And he strokes the three pretty well. Out on top he goes to DeMarco Johnson. This guy can do a lot of things. A little too hard on the leaner.
Good tap by John.
Yep, he just tapped it out to the wing for Joseph Tuomu. Georgetown and Charlotte tied at 6. We're almost 4 minutes into the West Regional in Tucson. This is John.
Page out of the ball game early. So the number one scorer sitting on the bench.
Jahidi White, and he was backing in. That'll be number one on him.
We talk about the thickness of White and Cool out there, and they will be pounding each other. Full court pressure, not guarding the man, taking the ball out of bounds. So far, it's been somewhat ineffective. Now, Tuomo is a very good defensive basketball player on Colson, so here's Johnson picking up, and a pretty good move by UNC Charlotte, because Ja is not used to picking up a man full court.
One way to get a leading rebounder away from the basket, and Johnson is so versatile, he's their most consistent player. There's the dump down to Cool, putting it on the floor, trying to scoop it underneath, and he and Jahidi White are going to be looking at each other all day long.
Pretty good offensive maneuver by Cool, who had his biggest game also against Alexander Cool from George Washington.
It was a cool day when they
got
together. Georgetown 20-9, number 10 seed in the West. They've beaten some NCAA teams like UMass, Nova. They took care of Providence twice. Two of their three losses came against Boston College.
Team that was able to weather the storm of the first round last night. Went over Valparaiso, that was had them down most of the ball game. And you know, one of the things that we're going to see, Bob, and I think it's already showing up a little bit in regard to teams that won postseason conference tournaments and had to go through three tough days, and then the emotion of winning the tournament, that maybe took a lot out of them. North Carolina and BC would be two good examples.
That answers that question.
Every 10 seconds or so, a stop sign goes up somewhere in America. And every 30 seconds, a traffic light goes up. It's as hard on your car as it is on you. It's stop and go. Stop and go. Stop and go driving. Use Pennzoil. Formulated for today's stop and go driving. Stop. Go. Pennzoil.
Excuse me. Think your disposable razor shaves as comfortably as his Gillette Sensor XL? Yeah. Well, try Sensor XL. It'll change your mind. After one shave with Sensor XL,
we bet you don't go back.
Because only Sensor XL has protective microfins for extra comfort.
Wow.
And self-adjusting blades for extra closeness. Disposables don't. And Sensor XL gives more shapes per blade than any disposable.
Excuse me.
Take the Sensor XL challenge. Bet you don't go back to disposables.
Hey, I want my Sensor XL back. Hey, hey!
I know a place.
America's a big country. Big. We like our skies big and our mountains extra large.
I'll take you there.
We purchased Louisiana. We bought Alaska. We wanted more beaches, so we added Hawaii. We love to spread out. That's why we gave the new Chevy Malibu more room for five than Camry, Accord, or Altima. And a bigger trunk than Taurus. So stretch out. It's the car you knew America could build. The brand new Chevy Malibu.
I'll take you there.
Tonight on The Late Show.
You want to see my thing?
A revealing interview with Roseanne. Plus.
What's happening, baby?
Martin Lawrence and Brooks and Dunn.
Woo!
Tonight.
Alexander Kuhl has four early in the 49ers of UNC Charlotte lead Georgetown by a score of 8-6. Bob Carpenter, Billy Packer, a great regional, Billy, for individual talent. We've got Brevin Knight of Stanford, Keith Van Horn of Utah, and Tim Duncan coming up later as well.
Three of the guys that, from the All-American standpoint, fared very well in their voting that we saw. And, of course, the National Player of the Year and Tim Duncan, consensus-wise.
And a very good balanced matchup to start the regional off with these two getting together. Conference USA against the Big East. Georgetown with it. Victor Page is still on the bench as leading the attack down this time is Ed Sheffy, their freshman guard out of Oak Hill. Way short from the corner. That was Shenard Long. And Georgetown ever swarming, getting the ball back.
UNC Charlotte's been in the man-to-man the entire day, and you see Kuhl staying back inside. The ball didn't hit the rim, so Sheffy does a great job recognizing it, and his teammates let him know that there are only 6 seconds left in the clock.
And about three by the time the ball actually went through. Georgetown back on top.
Georgetown picking up in the trap and then going back to this 2-3 matchup zone, which they've employed this entire first half so far.
UNC Charlotte at their best when they can run the break with Colson.
And also when they can get Johnson some shots. And so far he hasn't been able to get them. Here he goes. Nice crossover dribble.
Yeah, he created that shot. Had a pretty good look, but he missed it. And it was pulled right down by Versal Shaw. He's had a good game getting a start today. There's Shaw over the top. And he has a half dozen points.
I'd say he's playing a little better than good. Brought in there primarily as a defensive weapon. And hit every shot that he's put up and on the boards. And not hurting himself on the defensive end either.
Damon Jackson with the entry pass. There's Shenard Long, and he's 0 for 2. And Marco Johnson pulling it down for the 49ers of North Carolina Charlotte. They won the white division of Conference USA. Had a 10-4 record like Memphis did, but they won it on the tiebreaker. There's Sheffy in transition.
Oh, Shaw again. Terrific block coming over from the weak side.
He's living up to his nickname, Versatility.
And you know what was great? He told Kuhl, don't help picking me up. Get down on the other end of the floor.
Yeah. And then DeMarco Johnson goes right at Damon Jackson at the other end.
Shaw comes all the way across the lane. He can sense what's going to happen right here. Sheffy driving. And there he goes and blocks it with two hands and keeps it under control. Hits the floor and bounces back up to get the other end of the floor. Go to the other end of the court. And Page back at the ball game. Georgetown needs his scoring.
Some of you will be going to the Southeast Regional for the Trojans and the Fighting Illini. Tip off at 3:09. You'll be getting there on time. DeMarco Johnson hits the free throw. And this is Andre Davis, a senior guard out of Charlotte. Davis is their defensive stopper. And what a start for Versal Shaw. 6 points, a block shot.
Well, it helps to get Johnson untracked here, too. Those are his first two of the day. Young man shooting just under 80% and goes to the line often.
And Kuhl gets a breather as well as Tremaine Gardner is checked in. A sophomore swing man who gives them some power down low. Sheffy with the entry. That was Victor Page kicking the ball out on top to Yaya Ja.
Having all kinds of problem with Downs, who had to go out with that slight cut back in the ball game. And Page is his assignment.
It'll be key for Victor to get a basket before too much more time goes by. He's 0 for 2 today. He shot 16 for 57 in the Big East tournament.
Beautiful steal, and Colson, who's got great quickness from Gardner, to lay it up.
Tremaine Gardner, the man who made it happen, and John Thompson wants a 20-second timeout. Charlotte goes up by 5 with some transition. Day 2 of the NCAA tournament. Day 1 here in the West Region with UNC Charlotte on top by 5. Well, Dean Smith got the struggled last night, but did get number 876. The number 1 seed saw it came through. And how about the College of Charleston, Billy? Many feel that was not an upset at all when they took care of Maryland yesterday.
Well, I think we're seeing a couple of things that may have to do somewhat with seeding. College of Charleston, many people felt seeded much too low. And in the case of Georgia today being beaten by UT Chattanooga, maybe being seeded a couple of spots too high. So sometimes seeding can have to do with what happens in these early ball games. That's not to take anything away from those that were victorious.
Well, Mac McCarthy celebrates that new contract in Chattanooga with a big win today just moments ago.
Here's the box and one for the first time today. Davis now playing on Page. Now, this is a nice move by Coach Watkins because he has Page off to a slow start and doesn't want to see him get on track coming out of the timeout.
Andre Davis was the Metro Conference Freshman of the Year about 4 years ago. Had some academic problems, some off-the-court problems. He lost his scoring touch, but what a great defensive player he has become. He's the one on Page, upper left-hand corner of your screen. Rims out on Sheffy, and the rebound for Shandirick Downs of UNC Charlotte. And he's got the entry to DeMarco Johnson. A chance to face up.
Good job. Good job by Johnson to get that ball back outside. He sends the double team in the zone, gets it back out, and Downs hits.
Shandirick Downs, that's the 176th three of his career. And then at the other end, the tip away, the Hoyas will keep it. And Charlotte embarks on a 9-0 run. They're playing some good defense to create a few baskets and a couple of threes mixed in.
And the other thing that they're doing very well is they're not allowing Georgetown to score off of their defense, which is really something that Georgetown does extremely well. If they're going to have to beat you strictly in a half-court set, they've got problems. So the box and one stays on Page.
In the lane, it will not go for Boubacar Al, who just checked in. And the follow, a foul, as Yaya Ja did a good job on the offensive board. They average 70 points a game, but they just don't shoot very well. They shot 33% against Boston College, then 35 against Miami in the Big East tournament.
Well, when you think about Georgetown over all the years with the great defensive clubs that they've had, they always held their opponents down under 40%. But now when you look at their team, they're shooting under 40% offensively. So you just can't overcome from a standpoint of the victories and the losses when you don't have some offensive power. We're talking about Reggie Williams. We're talking about Patrick Ewing. We're talking about Allen Iverson. We're talking about some great offensive players that have come through the Georgetown program. It always started with defense, but they did have the ability to score on the other end of the floor as well. Not this year.
Yaya Ja gets them both. And just over 8 minutes in, it's the 49ers by 6.
With the Vortec engine in a Chevy S10, you can go around the world 4 times before you have to stop for a tune-up. Have a nice trip. Chevy S10, like a rock.
Celebration is brought to you by the people who helped so many other people understand and enjoy cellular phones. Radio Shack, America's number one retailer of cellular phones. Surprised? We're not. We're just happy. Radio Shack, you've got questions, we've got answers. Activate now and get 1 year of free roadside emergency service.
You are all abnormally fast, and that makes you feel different. Let's start with you. Tell me your name and why you're here.
My name is Michael, and I'm fast.
My name is Randy, and I'm fast.
My name is Kenny, but I'm not that fast.
Kenny, you stole 75 bases last year. You've got Zoom air in your shoes. Try it again, okay?
My name is Kenny, and I'm fast, but not as fast as him.
Kenny, we can't like you until you like you. We're all on your side.
Is your dandruff sending the wrong signals? Get Selsun Power. Doctors recommend Selsun Blue number one. So don't send the wrong signals. Get Selsun Power.
Enterprise, hi, I'm at the repair shop. I need to rent a car.
Enterprise will arrange to pick you up.
This is great.
Drive you to our place and get you on your way. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
The powerful drug cartel holds America hostage with the ultimate killing machine. Now only Chuck Norris can stop them.
Let's do it! Man to man.
Walker, CBS Saturday.
Well, you gotta be strong to take care of business if you're a cheerleader at the first round of the West Regional. Hoya's down by six. Teams are cold so far. But over the years, John Thompson and company have been right in the thick of things in terms of making tournament appearances, counting a couple of NITs. This is his 23rd straight postseason.
Well, Melvin Watkins put Denny Crum out of Conference USA tournament with a victory in the postseason conference tournament. Now he's trying to knock John out of the NCAA tournament. Here we see that matchup zone again by Georgetown.
Yeah, and they found DeMarco Johnson up at the high post. He found a little seam in there, Billy, and then turned and knocked it down very quickly.
Absolutely correct. He saw the hole in the defense, which is a nice move on his part. Good, smart play. And there we see that box and one staying there. As long as UNC Charlotte can keep Page off that scoreboard, the better off that they are. And I think this is an excellent move on their part.
Georgetown only 3 out of 12 so far. Bounce pass down to Yaya Ja. Fronting him was DeMarco Johnson. There's Victor Page. He can't shake Shandirick Downs and throws up the short air ball.
Great job by Downs to stay on the ground and not go for the pump fakes.
And it's very simple. If you can stop Page, you can beat this team. Then Carolina Charlotte brings it down, and a little unforced error there on the turnover. And those of you waiting to see USC and Illinois, the Southeast Regional, that tip-off's coming up in a matter of moments. We will get you there on time to watch the Trojans and the Illini.
Bad pass.
Downs with the steal.
Terrific job. Second time today, Gardner's come up with a loose ball.
Versal Shaw now fires on top for Colson, so the turnover does not hurt Charlotte that time. Georgetown gives it up for the fifth time.
Yeah, they're really confused offensively. They can't get Page on track.
Shaw, nice one in touch.
Is that 4 for 4?
He's 4 for 4. He's averaging 19 and a half minutes a game, and he may have to play about 30 the way he's shooting today.
Well, Watkins didn't win Coach of the Year in Conference USA for nothing. I mean, he decided to start Shaw, knew what he was doing.
Bubakar out the turnaround as well. Strong rebound, Tremaine Gardner.
Gardner doing a fine job. Two big steals, solid rebound. Johnson wide open inside. He'll score there.
Yeah, Colson found him, but he was well off to the left with it. Transition for Georgetown, Bubakar out.
Boy, you look at Georgetown and you say, where can the points come from? Al doesn't want to shoot the ball. Page does, can't get the ball. There's Shaw doing a good job.
That's Victor Page trying to go down low to get a layup. And now they're without a field goal for 5.5 minutes as we've just moved beyond the halfway point. The big fella, 7'2", 296, Alexander Kuhl will check back in.
You know, you think of Allen Iverson moving on, and there was a guy that with Page would be a devastating 1-2 combination. You wouldn't be able to box in one a Page if you had an Iverson around, or vice versa. But to lose that much offense really put this team in bad shape.
Great look down to DeMarco Johnson from Colson.
I believe it was Shaw again.
You're right. Versal Shaw is in the
double figures. 5 for 5.
And John Thompson's going to call another 20-second timeout. Charlotte by 12 early. We all knew that if Victor Page got off to a slow start, it could be a tough one for Georgetown. But we really didn't expect this. Billy, this was supposed to be one of the better balanced matchups in this Western region. The late game tonight, Stanford, Oklahoma looks like a dandy. St. Mary's will have to come up very big against Duncan and company, as will Navy against Utah.
Without, but you said the markup, the matchups here include those marquee matchups to come. Because Revan Knight, with his outstanding play throughout the course of this year, Tim Young, who certainly is to be an All-American from Stanford, and then you have Van Horn and, of course, Tim Duncan to be seen yet in this region. And you know what UNC Charlotte's doing? They're packing that box and winning even further now. And one of the things that you see, not only Georgetown having problems from a scoring standpoint, they really don't have a team.
Alexander slamming it home, a half dozen for him, and it's 25-11.
Beat Jahidi White down the floor, did Cool.
And then Colson beat everybody else.
There's a push off on the inside.
Yeah.
Colson, nice job. Really sees well on the court. The pass a little bit low, but Cool did a pretty good job for a big man catching that ball thrown slightly behind him in a little low. Good concentration on his part.
Charlotte by 14.
And John asked for a little half-court trap here, trying to create something again with his defense. Can't get it done with offense. There it is.
Sheffy to Page, and Victor will finish. And that is his first basket of the day.
Nice job by John Thompson, realizing he's got to generate offense with his defense, drop back in the 2-3 zone, and then jumped out. Colson ought to be able to handle that, particularly when he sees the guys coming at him.
Good ball movement. Cool again. He passes up the potential slam. Hey, why not? The hottest guy on the floor is Vershel Shaw. He has 12.
We're talking about a guy that averages 4 a game. There's another air ball. Downs was wide open.
Yeah, nobody saw him on the long pass. Colson for 3. Wow.
I was just going to say, not a good idea for the shot. He had Downs down in the corner. But that's one of those where the coach says no, no, and then says yes, yes.
Nobody was there to rebound, and it's 30-13 for the 49ers of UNC Charlotte. And the drive. Damon Jackson is stopped. It was Vershel Shaw in the middle of it again.
Jackson trying to go right into the heart of the defense.
Here's Shaw again.
Having a career day, gets fouled. Shaw here is only shooting 43%. He's only taken 3 three-point shots all year. Averaging, as we said, 4 points a game, but he has exploded in this first half to put Georgetown in a great deal of difficulty.
3 fouls on Jahidi White with that one. Vershel Shaw goes to the line where he shoots 71%.
You look back at Georgetown throughout the course of the year, they opened up at Cleveland State, you know, a repeat of the incredible championship between John Thompson and Raleigh Massimino. In that particular game, John was victorious at Cleveland State, 77-67. They beat Massachusetts, another team in the NCAA tournament, by 5. And they lost to Pacific on the West Coast.
Shaw with 13 and an early rout for UNC Charlotte.
Tiger Woods takes on Augusta National. The Masters on CBS.
Well, Visa Gold bought you the clubs and the clothes and 3 rounds at breathtaking Pebble Beach. The one thing it couldn't buy you was a single decent shot.
I quit! Finish without me!
I can't. Those were my clubs.
Fortunately, it had enough purchasing power for your next set of clubs.
Graphite.
Visa Gold, it's everywhere you want to be.
The forecast called for a calm, quiet meeting, but a tempest rages instead. It's often the case in today's international business climate, which is why the employee owners of United have prepared a place high above it all, with worldly comforts that refresh, restore, and renew. United Airlines. The calm before and after the storm. We don't just work here. Come fly our friendly skies.
Pizza Hut employee memo number 44. For Hoops fans, March brings one number to mind.
Four!
As in?
It's in the final four.
Right, so we're going to give them a deal that's easy to remember.
Back to work, everybody!
Give them a large pizza, a Pepsi, buffalo wings, and breadsticks.
That's four things.
Four things?
For four people.
For $4 each?
Yep, that's four things.
For $4 each?
For four people.
You guys are quicker than a point guard. Of course, once fans hear about this deal, you're not going to have time to work on that hook shot.
Oh. Nothing, nothing, nothing.
They will be here.
I don't see anything.
The guidebook says this is the place.
Whose idea was this?
Introducing Chevy Venture, the minivan with the widest dual sliding doors.
So where are they?
Slipping in and out has never been so easy.
Honey, maybe we ought to go further down.
Let's go.
All new Chevy Venture is here.
Let's go.
Let's go.
This is obviously not the spot.
All right, with a score 31-13 in the first half, let's take you around the country, show what's going on elsewhere in the tournament. A 15-2 game here. Pat O'Brien along with Clark Kellogg in our New York studios, and South Carolina leads Coppin State 18-14. A sloppy game here so far, Clark.
Yeah, they've been throwing it all over the place. South Carolina very good with the ball typically, but in the early going had a number of turnovers, and that's allowed Coppin State to maintain contact with them.
In fact, the teams combined for 11 turnovers in the first 10 minutes of this ball game. Three-point game now with a number two seed up by three. Coppin State out of the MEAC. Teams from that conference are 0-15 all time in the tournament.
They're off to a good start now, and they're fairly athletic, and they match up pretty good with South Carolina, and that's what you want to look at. Sometimes forget about the seeds, take a look at the individual matchups.
South Carolina has lost just twice since the first of the year. Both those defeats in the hands of Georgia. Keep you up to date on this one. Let's go out to Kansas City right now. Boston U and Tulsa, 17-9. Tulsa up, 10:09 left in the half at Kansas City.
Strong defense by Tulsa thus far. You see BU unable to get any good looks, and the few good looks they get, not able to knock any of them down.
BU shooting is ice cold. Tunji Awojobi, 3 points on a three-pointer. That's not a good deal. Tulsa's been on a 12-2 run here.
They're a physical team, and they're deeper than BU. The key for Boston University is Awojobi has to have a big game inside, and they've got to be able to knock down their perimeter shot.
How about the boards, too? Tulsa out-rebounding BU 10-2.
Well, they go with the three-guard lineup, does BU, and that means Awojobi and Joey Beard are battling typically three bigger guys in the paint area. That's why perimeter shooting is so key for Boston University.
First appearance in 7 years. College basketball gets a resurgence up in the New England area. I like that up there.
Getting pounded on the glass again. Is Tulsa able to get another opportunity? And it's buffet style on the glass there, Pat.
Kidding.
Plenty of seconds.
Big game from Michael Ruffin so far, too, Clark. 8 points so far.
He's a warrior inside. Attacks that offensive glass.
See if they get the rebound there. Now they got it back. So Boston U trails. 17-9 is the score. And we'll have highlights and scores and live action for you later. Let's go over to Charlotte now, at the Charlotte Coliseum, where USC and Illinois just underway. And it's 9-4 Illinois.
Good matchup here. Illinois, one of the best three-point shooting teams in the country. As a team, 38%. USC, volatile, but explosive. This team forces 20 turnovers a game. They get about 30 points off their bench, and that could be a factor for them. USC. Fairly deep and athletic.
USC at the line now, really surprised to be in this tournament.
I think Texas Tech not being included, making themselves ineligible because of the academic problems, certainly may have helped USC get in.
I'm just going to say they're probably writing thank you letters at Texas Tech. All right, let's go back to Tucson. That's what's going on in around the country. Let's go back to Bob Carpenter and Billy Packer. 31-15 is the score now. See you later.
In
And for the first time today, Georgetown scores two consecutive times down the floor. They get a layup from Damon Jackson that time. Boubacar Ao in transition.
In transition, he got by with a walk there, Bob. But for John Thompson, it's something that you're happy to see.
Charlotte calls it 20 to put a stop to things with 4:55 remaining in the first half. Georgetown really had sort of an up-and-down season on December 29th till January 25th. They just really went into a lull. They were 3-6. They couldn't shoot. Then they got a big win over Nova. They closed the Big East season with a record of 8-1. Had some momentum going into the tournament.
Well, they came in first place in the Big East 7, so that momentum was there for the Big East tournament. But again, it is so difficult for them because everything becomes such a job for them to score. There's Shaw with another good play. And really a huge difference between these two clubs are the hands of the players.
Urso Shaw with 13 points and 3 steals so far. Illinois off to a good early start against South Carolina, who had such a great year in the SEC. That's Davis with the steal, and DeMarco Johnson will get the charge.
That's a big turnaround right there for UNC Charlotte because they're ready to put some more points back on the board. Georgetown now starting to pick up a little bit of momentum. Davis looks like he either hurt his ankle or his hip. He's going to sit down.
Jermaine Gardner back in for UNC Charlotte. That's taking a seat. Yaya Ja for Georgetown.
And they go man-to-man now. I really like the way that Melvin Watkins has changed his defensive assignments around. Downs back there on Page. And they have confused Georgetown.
That was Gardner over the top, nearly stealing it for UNC Charlotte.
See, they did not recognize at Georgetown that the box and one was no longer on. Now, let's see if UNC Charlotte will start taking some better shot selections. You know, sometimes you think you've got a blowout-type lead. They're only up 31-17. They've taken some real bad shot selections the last half dozen times down the court.
12 Georgetown turnovers already. Cool missing on the slam. Loose ball picked up by Damon Jackson of Georgetown. That possession arrow is pointing back the other way. They tried to call a timeout, but it didn't work.
Well, Downs got away with a foul on that play. It looks like he jammed his finger. So Davis on the bench with the hip that's hurt, and now it looks like Downs has hurt his finger.
Officials timeout with 3:45 to go first half. North Carolina Charlotte on top by 14.
See you tomorrow.
I go right. I was strong as I could be. I go right. Nothing ever got to me.
With a powerful Vortec engine in a Chevy truck, you can go 100,000 miles before the first scheduled tune-up. Great news, especially when you live 100,000 miles from nowhere.
Oh, no.
In 1948, who could have imagined the rage over TV, let alone a PC? FYI, Kemper did. And those who followed our long-term investment discipline found a new world of financial discovery, like Kemper Technology Fund, where $10,000 invested in 1948 would have tuned you into $3.9 million last December. Ask your financial advisor about the thinking behind every Kemper fund. Long-term investing in a short-term world.
Budner, get these tax documents to our clients fast, but watch our costs.
FedEx can deliver it in 2 days for about $8. UPS can deliver it in 2 days for about $7.
Priority Mail can deliver it in 2 to 3 days for $3.
Smart move, Budner.
So, 8, 7, 3, what's your priority? Switch to Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service.
Monday Super Bowl MVP Desmond Howard showboats with Ray.
Hey, show me what you got.
I didn't come with much. Show me something.
Everybody loves Raymond, CBS Monday.
Well, Georgetown simply not shooting the basketball very well. They're 6 of 21. Charlotte's already had 30 attempts in the game, and thus a lot of points off 12 Georgetown turnovers so far.
The turnovers have been in the backcourt and obviously have led to almost immediate baskets. And, you know, Bob, there's a couple of others that they could have scored on just as easily on some of those turnovers.
John Thompson witnessing a very sloppy effort by his club so far. And there was, Colson is pushed.
There was the 2-3 zone and coming out to try to pick up with a little half-court trap, but Colson is extremely quick. He passes extremely well also right off the dribble. It's amazing how Cool is able to catch some of those passes because they're pretty quick.
Ed Sheffy on the foul. And going to the line will be Sean Colson.
Second team all-conference player this year. All-tournament. Made the all-tournament team. Had 17 assists this year in a game against Houston with only one turnover.
And that's
a new record. Nobody picking up all.
Hubakar all the way, and then he's fouled on the way down.
I guarantee you Melvin Watkins did not like that play. Second time, nobody has picked up all on the dribble.
Pat O'Brien and Clark Kellogg coming up on Penn Soil at the half. All the tournament news, scores, and highlights. A live look at all the action that's going on at that time. It's all coming up on Penn Soil at the half. Joseph Tuomo back into the game for Georgetown.
Now you think about the problems that Georgetown has getting Page untracked here today. Earlier this year, Page had a similar type game against St. John's where he was couldn't get untracked the whole game until the key basket right at the end for a Georgetown win against St. John's.
That was Shandurek Downs on the rebound for UNC Charlotte. After Alexander Cool's second foul resulted in the free throws. 31-18, 3:20 before halftime, and stepping out of bounds was Roderick Howard.
Well, Colson getting a little bit of a well-deserved blow there, and Howard going to be the primary ball handler. And now they're back to the box and one, so constantly changing defenses from the 2-3 matchup zone to the man-to-man to the box and one, and all pretty effective.
On the back door, the rebound, Shandurek Downs.
That's what I was talking about, Bob. Good hands. This Charlotte team really has. Everybody on the club can really catch the ball. One of Georgetown's problems, particularly with their bigger guys, they're really shaky catching.
Georgetown really extending that defense right now. That's Sheffy on the foul.
Smart play by Shaw. As soon as he felt a little action, let the ball hit the floor so he could use his dribble again. This young man has been the key to the ball game so far. You know, he should be somewhat familiar with the Big East because he's a former high school teammate of Kerry Kittle's, the great star from Villanova last year. And it's kind of interesting. John Thompson made a living with recruiting kids from New Orleans. And now we have a situation with UNC Charlotte getting some kids from down in New Orleans.
Georgetown rebound by Yaya Ja. It was an entry pass. Cool, the rebound after the ball was just dumped into the lane by Bubakar Al.
Al, not a shooter, but previously has been a pretty good ball handler. They're having some problems with Howard as opposed to Colson on that point, and Colson's coming back in the game.
Yaya Ja, much bigger than the ball handler, Roderick Howard, who's only 5'10", 185. Job falling on him as they tumbled over the near sideline, so they're going back to the line again.
Well, Howard with 39 threes this year, being used as the primary ball handler, as I said, with Colson out of there. Yaw takes him right to the floor, unfortunately not hurt.
Roderick Howard with his first point of the day. He normally starts at the two spot. That's where Shandurek Downs started today. Damon Jackson checking in for Georgetown.
Of course, that created by because Shaw was moved into the starting lineup, so Downs just shifted over.
And how smart does Melvin Watkins look?
Absolutely.
Howard with his first two of the day. down to the 227 mark. And Sean Colson, the starting point guard, is back. He played at Rhode Island back in 95.
And Davis comes back in the ball game, so it's good to see that he's not hurt too badly. And he's going back to take his assignment on the box and one runner against Page. Pretty good screen that time by Ayanda.
Victor well short with it. Rebound Cool straight ahead. Colson losing control, and Victor Page made that one happen in the backcourt.
Well, give Page some credit. You're not doing well offensively, but you can still hustle on the defensive end of the floor. Colson really loves to push the ball up the floor.
Victor Page has one basket today.
You can see he's trying to curl off the inside screeners. Nice pass.
And found Damon Jackson in the back door. Nice speed by Yaya Ja. Damon Jackson with four. It's 33-20. North Carolina Charlotte's offense has stalled here in the last few minutes.
Well, they had everything going pretty well in sync, and then they took some bad shots from the outside, some jumpers, particularly those two by Bundy.
Look at Colson.
Oh, some touch. That ball just died on the rim.
Yeah, it looked like it had some stick-em. And then Sheffy at the other end a little long with it. Strong rebound up in the air by Roderick Howard.
Well, it was Davis with the rebound. It was playing Page one-on-one and went way in the air and went over Page. He's a pretty good leaper.
Andre Davis at only 6'1", the man who replaced Howard at 5'10". Long rebound comes out to Sheffy. Hoyas are running. Tough pass handled there by Boubacar Al.
A little shaky again on the catch.
Page still can't knock it down, but there's Zhao on the back door. Boubacar with seven here in the first half.
Dangerous pass down back court. Throw the ball cross court under the basket. It's intercepted. You're in trouble.
Nice hands. Cool. Hammered on the way up. He was about to slam it home. They isolated him on Victor Page over there.
And again, look at the good hands involved in the play. Now, there is Colson on that drive. Watch how this ball just hangs on the rim and falls on through. Normally, the English you'd put on this ball would have it just hit that rim and just come spinning on out of there. That one just died. These are pretty good shooting rims. We noticed yesterday in the practice sessions, ball usually hits and dies up there.
Alexander Cool, 6 points and five rebounds today.
Cool last summer played for the German national team, and of course, unfortunately, he had that foot injury that he had in July, but he's come back pretty well. It looks like he's in really well conditioned for a guy who obviously couldn't work out recuperating from that injury.
He's now 3 out of 6 from the line with that make. Ursel Shaw, who had the great start, back in for North Carolina Charlotte. Cool will have a breather. They don't want him to get a third foul before halftime.
And you want to be able to hold the ball with your better ball handlers here, getting the ball back for the last shot. They'll have one last chance at it.
Final 40 seconds. And the kick by Shandurek Downs. 35 on the shot clock. Just about a second and a half less than the game clock, as the Hoyas have scored only 22 points here in the first 20 minutes.
You know, when you think of underrated teams, you'd have to say UNC Charlotte. Over the course of the year, Bob, what they were doing in Conference USA, they weren't getting a lot of national credit for it.
Right.
But you can see it's a very versatile basketball team, pretty deep, excellent primary ball handler. And we're looking at a team that's got a nice lead like this without their leading scorer having a big day. So DeMarco Johnson hasn't been a major factor here.
Shot clock down. So's the game clock. That's Page wheeling and dealing.
Great help.
Knocked away from him. Sheffy throws up a prayer and tipped at the last moment. Nothing doing for Georgetown. That's the end of the first half with the score. North Carolina Charlotte 36 and Georgetown 22. CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship will continue after this message.
They say the 50s were the golden age of television. But today we can actually use our TVs to surf the internet. So we can go places we always dreamed of going. Find out about almost anything. Hear things we've never heard before.
Amazing. Web TV from Philips Magnavox. The power of the internet now on your own television.
Oh. someone your own size.
The Star Wars trilogy is back on the big screen, and it's even better with a Pepsi.
Great effects, man.
Yeah. Go where you wanna go. Find the road you've never taken.
Introducing the all-new Goodyear Wrangler ATS with dual-traction lug channels that evacuate water for serious traction in the wet, especially in braking. The all-new Goodyear Wrangler ATS.
Serious freedom.
Halftime here, 36-22, another game heading to halftime. Let's get you over there quickly out to Pittsburgh, Coppin State, and South Carolina. It's a two-point game, 34-32. Let's go courtside with John Sumbold, and here's Mike Gorman.
The shot clock is off. Coppin State, a chance to tie the game or take the lead here with the three as we wind down the first half in Pittsburgh. A great show by the Eagles, who just will not go away. Deep three, in and out. Rebound follow underneath. No, another rebound follow. That might be Wilborn over the back with the foul.
Well, right now, the quickness of Coppin State has frustrated South Carolina. Their fans and the fans around here are now. Coppin State is the favorite in this crowd. But look at the activity. Big Wilborn fighting them all by his lonesome inside. And two Coppin State players going at it. Wilborn picks up the foul. But you can tell the 15th seeded team now is drawing attention from fans from all the teams here in Pittsburgh.
Fred Warwick will have a chance to tie the game with 5.5 seconds to go in the first half. The South Carolina faithful here in Pittsburgh trying to get behind their club. But the other 17,000 or so in this building have suddenly become Fang Mitchell fans.
Well, round one for this ball game goes to Fang Mitchell's team. They're going to go into halftime feeling very good about them seeing their team, but expect Eddie Fogler to make some adjustments. Their guards have to get on track. Not playing well at all.
Out of bounds. Last touch. Oh, it's going to come back to Coppin State.
Again, a nonchalant pass as they took the ball out of bounds. Wilburn just simply threw it to half court. Coppin State will not allow those easy passes to get through. They knock it out, have a chance to take the lead.
You can see the folks in Pittsburgh here are getting behind the Coppin State Eagles. 3.5 seconds to go here in the first half. South Carolina uncharacteristically turning the ball over a ton here today.
You know, against a zone defense, which doesn't happen very often, but let's give Coppin State credit. A matchup zone defense that has been very active with their feet and their hands, and I just think South Carolina's been a little lethargic with the ball and did not come out to play this afternoon.
Ball is tipped, stolen. Larry Davis has guarded half court. He's got a chance. And we will go to the locker room. At the half. That's the end of the first half. It's 34 all. Pat O'Brien and Clark Kellogg will be along with Pennzoil at the half after this message and a word from your local station.
The Chevy S10 Sports Side. Coolest thing to come on the back of a truck since the Nutty Buddy. Chevy S10 Sportside, like a rock.
A sweeping saga of the American frontier.
Return both the women, or there will be a battle.
An epic adventure based on a true story. Stolen Women, CBS Sunday.
CBS.
Welcome home.
There are many different ways to prepare beef, but only one kind to buy. U.S. Choice Beef. It's the only kind you'll find at Winn-Dixie. See the beef people today and save while a whole boneless ribeye is only $3.78 a pound, cut and wrap free. Save again on delicious fryer leg quarters, a super low 48 cents a pound. And harvest fresh leafy green cabbage is only 18 cents a pound. Winn-Dixie. More choices, low prices.
Cheese. Some say it's the heart and soul of a perfect pizza. That's why Papa John's uses real mozzarella. It costs us a little more. Us, not you. But the taste is definitely worth it. That's one reason why Papa John's is now the fastest growing pizza company in America. Call and we'll deliver all the delicious reasons right to your door. Better ingredients, better pizza. Papa John's.
Pick five for a real winner. Papa's Choice. Up to five toppings plus 2 liter Coke for just $10.99.
Here we are, sunny Phoenix, all for free.
And all we had to do was tell a little lie.
Now, telling the truth gets you nowhere.
At British Airways, we'll give you a free ticket to anywhere in the USA if you fly our business class to London and can honestly say it's not the best in the air.
What'd you get in a done?
Parties.
Really?
Eagled it.
The business class guarantee.
Can't believe we got away with it.
Honestly, you'll love it.
Spring into action during the spring sales event at your Super 10 Toyota dealer.
Yes, we've ordered early. We've ordered extra, and now is the time to act.
New 97 Tacoma pickups, lease for $149 a month.
Or get $1,200 cash back when you buy.
Extra cabs, $189 a month.
4x4s, just $219 a month.
Tacoma has more cargo space, bigger payload, more horsepower, and a better resale value than S10 or Ranger. The choice is clear.
Spring into action with a new 97 Tacoma pickup.
Shop one of your Super 10 Toyota dealers today.
Page isn't either. He's got 2 points, 1 of 9 for shooting, really in a cold spot here. And Hoya is expected to do a lot better than this, Clark. The 49ers, though, I'm sorry, came out shooting, didn't they?
Yeah, they've got good balance inside and outside. Shaw can knock it down. Open jumper here, bang.
Melvin Watkins likes what he sees early. The Hoyas answer back, though. Ed Sheffy drives, nails the pull-up three there. But Charlotte has offense and defensive skills today.
Mm-hmm. And if you keep Georgetown off the offensive glass, you've got a chance to, obviously, off the turnover, you can do this, get out and get an easy one.
Hoya's shooting just 27%, and there's how it shows, 36-22 at the half. John's got a lot of talking to do at halftime. South Carolina and Coppin State knotted at 34. Coppin State came swinging into their third tournament appearance against the number 2 seed, Larry Davis. Watch him get the steal and the save off the inbound. Then Melvin Watson gets it down to Herbert Lee Davis ahead of the pack for the highlight film jam, and he was right. He got in. Coppin State answers right back. Danny Singletary.
They've done a nice job turning turnovers into points here, but otherwise they've just had a very solid half at both ends of the floor.
All right, there's your score. A little bit of a surprise, a lot of a surprise, mm-hmm. actually. 34-34 at halftime. Also at halftime in Kansas City, Boston U and Tulsa. BU can't get much done this afternoon, and the Terriers of BU hustling early, though. Joey Beard receives a long pass after a nice save by LeVar Folk and scores. But Tulsa, I'm telling you, they're putting it together this afternoon.
They're doing a great job defensively. No easy looks for the Terriers, and they're also doing a good job on their own offensive board.
Tunji Awajobi, just 3 points on that three-pointer early. He is suffering from a head cold, so that could explain part of that. But they trail 40-19 at halftime. Now, down in Charlotte, UNC and Illinois underway. 7:55 left before halftime, and Illinois leads 27-19. Let's go to Charlotte Coliseum in North Carolina to Tim Brando and George Raveling.
Game two of round one here in the Southeast region in Charlotte, North Carolina. The Illini leading by 8, shooting better than 60%,
as did UT Chattanooga in game one in their upset of third-seeded Georgia.
They await the winner of this afternoon's matchup between Big Ten Illinois and Pac-10 USC. Rhodes is trapped. Gives it up, finds Wilson. Quality read by Roderick Rhodes. 6 points for Jaha Wilson.
What made that play was that Illinois trapped Rhodes with two small guards. His size allowed him to see over top of the trap and find the open man.
USC now 8 of 17 from the floor. The Illini 11 of 16. Shooting at a tarred clip, but Kewan Garris has been well defended. He only has 3 points in this game. Up top, Turner. He has been the answer for Garris's double
bucket
team.
Is 30-21. With that bucket is 30-21. 7:04 left in the half. We'll keep you up to date on that. Thanks for joining us on Pennzoil at the Half. Enjoy the second half on CBS.
Pennzoil at the Half was sponsored by Pennzoil, the first motor oil to fully meet the new tougher GF2 standard.
Every 10 seconds or so, a stop sign goes up somewhere in America. And every 30 seconds, a traffic light goes up. It's as hard on your car as it is on you. It's stop and go. Stop and go. Stop and go driving. Use Pennzoil. Formulated for today's stop and go driving. Stop. Go. Pennzoil.
Every game, my teammates depend on me, so I have to be in control. There's no way I would let them or myself down by using drugs. Stay in control. Don't use drugs.
If you or someone you know needs help or information concerning drug abuse, call this toll-free number, 1-800-662-HELP. This message provided by the NCAA.
Oh, I think it's the purest game. There's no helmets, there's no shoulder pads, there's no equipment. There's faces and bodies, 10 players, and an open court so everyone can see exactly what's going on. And I think it's just a pure athletic contest. Well, basketball at our level is a 12-month sport for me. What that means is that I have to keep myself in shape now 12 months a year. And then in August and September, I've got to take that program up another notch. Because when I go out there in December, I have to be ready to go up and down with those young people because they're in shape and they have the right to expect me to be in shape. Through basketball, I've established friends in the officiating, coaching, administrating, conference office people who I hope will be friends of mine for the rest of my life. And I think that's one of the things when it's all done that I'll remember most and have to remember and have with me for the rest of my life, when long after I'm retired.
This message provided by the NCAA.
While you're rocking on the road to the Final Four, jump on the Information Expressway. CBS Sports is online with the breaking news and the latest scores at cbs.sportsline.com.
Halftime in Tucson, Carolina, Charlotte over Georgetown by 14. And Billy, the versatile Shaw has really come up big in the first half of this game.
Well, without question, we're going to see DeMarco Johnson. Everybody thinks going to get the ball. He's going to clear out. There's going to be a little bit of a screen in here. We're going to see some rolling off to the side, and Shaw gets the ball down in low. A terrific job by UNC Charlotte. Here you see Shaw coming in. He just rubs them off, gets the ball down in low, and scores. In the first half, he had 13 points, 6 for 8. We're talking about a young man that only averages 4 a game, known for his defense, but he's really been an offensive threat today.
And we're back to Tucson after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship.
You know how one dog year equals 7 human ones? Computers are like that compared to other machines. A 7-year-old airplane is younger than a 1-year-old server. It makes buying decisions tough. It turns systems into orphans way too soon. Computer people ought to be sensitive to that. No matter how great the new stuff is that you've worked with, even optimize their old stuff. Digital does it. Everybody should.
Digital. Whatever it takes.
CBS. Welcome home.
Ever noticed that a lot of successful people drive Jeep Grand Cherokees? Well, maybe that's because they're smart enough to know a great deal when they see one. Like this incredible lease deal of just $299 a month. You get the safety of anti-lock brakes, dual airbags, and the power of 185 horses. Just $299 a month for a limited time. So don't miss this great opportunity, because who knows, a Jeep Grand Cherokee might be just the thing to help you with your climb to the top.
Jeep and Eagle, the official vehicles of the Carolina Panthers.
Dell set up for three. Yes. Hornets fans, with the Hornets making a playoff run, how would you like to join the team on the road for a first-round playoff game? Just stop by your nearest participating Charlotte area AutoZone location and register. You could win a trip for two, including round-trip coach airfare, double occupancy hotel accommodations, and great game tickets. So get into the zone with the Hornets for the playoffs with AutoZone, WBTV, and the Charlotte Hornets.
When it comes to wireless communications, experience makes the difference. And when it comes to experience, come to Bell Atlantic 9X Mobile.
To celebrate the expansion of the Super System, enjoy big savings on a variety of great cellular phones. Plus, talk all you want until June with unlimited night and weekend local airtime. Free activations, too.
Only one company has the Super System. 30,000 square miles of home rate calling and proven experience for all your wireless communications. For cost and coverage, there's only one. Bell Atlantic 9X Mobile.
How can a car win Strategic Vision's Total Quality Award, have more room than Chevy Lumina, more power than Toyota Camry, more standard features than Ford Taurus, and still have a price this reasonable? It's puzzling. Dodge Intrepid. This changes everything. See the cars and trucks of the Carolina Panthers at your hometown Carolina Dodge dealers.
Man-to-man second half, and Page is now 1-for-10. And that was Alexander Kuhl stepping on the baseline. When you're outscored 36-22 and shoot 28%, you better not turn the ball over. But Georgetown did that 13 times. Now Page goes right at the big fella, and that's number three early on Alexander Kuhl.
Well, Kuhl got the block and the ball, but he hit him with his body.
His first personal, first team foul.
We're talking about a young man here who last year as a freshman was the MVP of the Big East tournament. Had a sensational ball game, 34 against Villanova in the semis. But having his problems here today.
Victor Page with only his third point of the game.
And how long will Melvin Watkins go with Kuhl with those three fouls? He went small in the first half.
Sean Colson had three assists with a couple of rebounds and 7 points in the first half.
Colson played 2 years at Rhode Island. Beautiful, beautiful pass. And there is Shaw again.
Versal Shaw with 15 on Colson's fourth assist of the day.
He's the number one assist man in Conference USA at 6.3, and showing you why, particularly off the dribble.
There's Ja for Jahidi White, trying to bull his way on, and Kuhl blocked that one. John Colson fights away from the half-court trap.
And there's Shaw again, being at the right place at the right time to provide a place for Colson to throw the ball.
Rebound, Yaya Ja for Georgetown. Jeffy on the wing for Page. Victor finally gets a three. So with a couple of free throws in that shot, he has 5.5 and 7 in the game.
One of the first times today the UNC Charlotte did not get back with good defensive transition, and it cost them.
And despite all the problems, Georgetown down by just 11.
Georgetown in that 2-3 matchup in the first half just about the whole time. Now they're man-to-man. Nice job by Jahidi White.
We're going to have a Georgetown foul. Jahidi White, another guy who's playing with a bunch of fouls.
You see the lob on the inside. White gets back there. That was the pass from Colson to Shaw earlier in the half. Terrific job by Colson to spot him.
It was Victor Page with his second foul on that play. Jahidi White, the loose ball. And ahead it goes to Carl Owl. And where were the 49ers that time?
We mentioned about defensive transition. 3-on-0 fast break. That happened because Colson was down caught inside.
Yeah, transition is a word with two different meanings, isn't it? Pushing the ball, but also getting back.
Absolutely. Sheffy doing a good job of giving Colson a lot of trouble here so that he's having to occupy him on the dribble. Make it a little bit difficult to hit inside.
DeMarco Johnson for Versal Shaw, and he pushes home another one. He's had 17 now.
Oh, it has to be one. But that's Shaw again with another outstanding play. Down on the inside, Shaw goes, tries to draw the charge. The ball hits him. He's sliding out of bounds, and he's either going to be called for walking or out of bounds, but you know, Shaw got hurt on that play. He's not getting up off the ground very well.
Andre Davis is set to check back in for North Carolina Charlotte.
Davis had a solid first half, but nothing like Shaw. He took quite a shot trying to draw the charge. Well, he had taken 16 of them coming into the game to lead this club, so he's used to taking some contact.
But he has been their defensive stopper today. He's been both defensive and offensive catalyst for this team.
That was Shanderick Downsmere with the steal. He got poked in the eye. Victor Page is starting to light it up, and now 9 for him.
Now, here's what we're having right now is Victor Page, first of all, Downs gets hit in the nose. And he goes down on the floor. Victor Page, with nothing intentional at all, happened to hit him the second time. Downs thought it was intentional. There you see him going down. He grabs Page by the leg. The referee did not see the first shove, saw the second one. We'll see it right here. I think it was really a trip. I don't think Page intentionally knocked Downs to the floor. Without question, there's no doubt, though, that Downs intentionally grabbed Page. Now, that should be an intentional foul. Yep. 2 in the ball.
8-point spread as this one gets a lot closer. Utah and Navy. Wake Forest and St. Mary's coming up later. Then our late game is Stanford and Oklahoma tonight in this region. That should be a ball game of good balance with the Cardinal and the Sooners.
That was really a break right there for UNC Charlotte, and the fact it should have been an intentional foul. 2 shots on the ball, but instead they didn't even get a chance to shoot one, but get put on a good opportunity in the offensive glass.
Bubakar Al with the basket on the back door, and suddenly we've got a 6-point game at 40-34.
Kind of amazing. Georgetown coming back again. Defense has become their offense. And they're playing much better in an aggressive man-to-man than they were in the zone all over the back.
That should be Yaya Zhao on the back with his third.
And if you're UNC Charlotte, you see this good offensive board work by Georgetown. Al puts it back up. Nice soft touch and scores. In the offensive glass, and maybe the fact that John Thompson came out in the man-to-man defense got his guys moving their feet on the defensive end, so it's made him much more effective on the offensive end as well.
Andre Davis to throw it in on top to Alexander Kuhl. Then on for DeMarco Johnson, who for the most part has had a very, very quiet offensive game.
I think for UNC Charlotte to make a move here, they've got to get Johnson the ball. He's been a no factor.
That ball tipped by Joseph Tuomo. All the way back down to the other end, and Charlotte will pull it in. They got 19 seconds on the shot clock and the length of the court to go. And so Georgetown will put on some pressure here.
Excellent job by Georgetown here to go full court now in 19 seconds. Colson's going to have to push that ball up the floor.
3
Oh, wow. Defies all of the good strategy by John Thompson. Walks it up the floor and then buries one. It's a good move by John Thompson to go ahead out there and get his team moving by changing back to the man-to-man defense.
A basket Charlotte needed very badly. Now they're back on top by 9. Page almost had it taken away by Andre Davis. And here's Shaw.
What a game this young guy's having.
He's getting plenty of help. That's why they call Andre Davis the defensive stopper. And a big 5 in a row for Charlotte gets him back on top by 11.
There they're matching up back down to the box and one on Page with Davis on him.
Force on the way in, Joe Heidi White. That's Yaya Cha on the back door, and here's a home run pass. It's Davis. And a pass from Colson.
Right on the mark. Conference leading assist man. 2 brilliant assists here in the second half.
That was about a 75-foot bullet pass by the little guy.
There you can see this box and one. And no secondary scorer on the floor at all from the outside. Tuomo is not going to look to take any kind of shots whatsoever. So neither is Bubakar R. So where in the world is the shot going to come from?
So we've just witnessed a very significant sequence here in the second half. Georgetown got it back to 6. And then Charlotte gets 7 straight. Now Page misses. Bubakar is fouled as he drops down the follow.
No excuse for that particular breakdown by UNC Charlotte. Nobody on the weak side rebounding, and there's that baseball pass you were talking about, Bob. Maybe 80 feet right on the money. Davis breaking, nobody back. And what's difficult here
when you're in a box and one like this, and you're a guy like Page, you're trying to break free to get some open shots. You do that basically by running the baseline. If you're running the baseline, that means there's nobody back defensively at the guard position. So UNC Charlotte ought to be able to break long, as they did right there, and get an easy basket.
Ubakar out having a big day. His biggest game recently, 10 points with 8 boards against BC in the Big East tournament. He's got double his average with his 14 today. So he's the scorer, keeping Georgetown in it. Niners by 10.
Is what you drive a reflection of who you are? Or is who you are a reflection of what you drive? The answer, of course, depends on what you drive. And right now, for a limited time, you can lease the 1997 Aurora by Oldsmobile for just $399 a month. A proposition worth reflecting on. Aurora by Oldsmobile.
Quieter ride than you might ever expect from a 4x4 tire. Yet it's rugged enough, tough enough, Michelin enough to get you through anything. The LTX series from Michelin.
Everybody across the town from America is coming from the airport.
Did he rent from her?
Not exactly, but Sal got some deal.
Did he get computerized driving directions like her?
Not exactly, but he'll be here.
Excuse me.
Sal speaks Italian.
Excuse me.
Not exactly.
In Europe, there's Hertz and there's not exactly. Make sure you choose the right one.
It's me, Sal from America. Anybody up?
Not exactly.
Exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Bud Light, Oldsmobile, Nike, and by Michelin.
Victor Page and the Hoyas starting to show some signs of life, down by 10. But really, the story for Georgetown now is Boubacar Au, 14 points. And if he keeps doing things down low, Page may get some looks up high.
Well, in the box and one, you found a situation where Colson gets caught down on the weak side as a rebounder. And Boubacar Au has taken advantage of that, getting real strong on the glass. And here we see Georgetown again staying with the man-to-man. He's helped to pick up their intensity in the second half. Nice move by John Thompson.
Sean Colson running the point for Charlotte. DeMarco Johnson putting it on the floor. The pull-up, he's well off with it. Cool trying to keep it alive. And the ball pulled down by Shamel Jones of Georgetown. There's off. Can't quite drop it, but he does draw the foul as Vershel Shaw was trying to keep up with it. It's Tulsa looking in Kansas City today, all over BU. And Illinois over Southern Cal by 15 at the half as well.
Cool sits down on the inside. The key again, even though they have a 10-point lead, in my mind, is for UNC Charlotte to get DeMarco Johnson scoring. We're talking about a guy that is their leading scorer, averaging just under 20 a game. Has not been a factor offensively, and so consequently Georgetown taking advantage of it and getting some pretty good transition baskets here in the second half.
Nice pack on the upper right arm for Alexander Cool. That's Andre Davis handling it. He's in there for defense, hands it off to Sean Colson. Hoyas trying to trap all over the place. Davis thinking about the three.
Really wasn't in balance. You notice his feet were jumping back and forth. He couldn't get himself squared up.
That's the kind of shot he used to hit back in 93 when UNC Charlotte was in the Metro and he was the conference freshman of the year. cool with that ice pack near the elbow. So they get a little smaller with DeMarco Johnson in the middle. Some help from Versal Shaw, who's 6'7". He's the man following Bubakar out.
And with Cole out of there, they change your defense. They go to a straight man-to-man now. Johnson on Jahadi White down inside, really doing a lot of banging.
There's Yaya Ja looking over the top of the defense to Jahadi, and then Ja keeps following it in to finish it off.
Now, double down. Ja, who's an excellent student academically, was in basketball as well there because he recognized the double down, realizing nobody blocked him out and went right to the hole.
Well, you always hear coaches say, follow your shot. That time he followed his pass.
Well, exactly. And he's not being guarded out there. So, you know, there's two rules of thought on that. If a guy is not a good outside shooter, don't guard him out there. And then there are other guys that say you better go out there on him because if he does get it inside, you'll have nobody there to block out. And, of course, that's what happened on that play.
Victor Page just now getting to get his offense going, drawing his third foul on that play.
And he's matched up with Colson now, which could be a problem because Colson's a pretty good penetrator off that dribble.
Yeah, if he beats you, you got to let him go if you're Victor Page. The entry, DeMarco Johnson drew the double team. That's Gardner for Shaw. Versal missing short on that one.
Shaw again.
Wow, strong offensive rebound for Versal Shaw.
He really had a nose for the ball that time. You know, he didn't like the touch on his shot. As soon as he hit the floor, he took off for the offensive rebound.
So he knew there'd be a rebound out of his hands, huh?
There's the matchup I was talking about. He should have gone up with a shot against Page.
And the loose ball picked up by Tremaine Gardner with his first basket of the day.
First basket, but not first loose ball. That's Gardner's fourth or fifth time in this ball game. He's picked up a loose one.
And credit Versal Shaw with keeping possession for UNC Charlotte that time. They lead by eight with 12 and a half minutes to go here at the West Regional in Tucson.
With Cool out of the game, it looks like John really wants to go down inside. Nice help by Gardner there.
Page with the entry, Jahadi White. He's got to make that shot. With a hitter to call that picture goaltending on Yaya Ja.
And John Thompson knows what he wants to do offensively now, and that's to punch the ball down inside and have Ja go to the basket. That was a push off by Heidi White, got by with it. We're looking at a young guy that was one of the most highly recruited high school big men in the country. Went to Georgetown, and he's bulked up a great deal.
Out of Cardinal Ritter in St. Louis, where he was an All-American, Joseph Tuomo and Shamel Jones checked in at the whistle for John Thompson. That's Tremaine Gardner, who's done a lot of little things, as Billy mentioned, to help out the 49ers today. Colson running the point, Tuomu, the man guarding him. Victor Page is down low right now against Shandirick Downs.
Good screen by Gardner.
Colson from Shaw.
Another good screen by Gardner.
And the double team. Now they switch it. Down, straight down to DeMarco Johnson. They did it beautifully. They just didn't finish off the play.
That's a terrific job by Downs to recognize he wouldn't have the shot. But again, we're seeing the case.
8:15 out of halftime. It's North Carolina Charlotte by eight.
Johnson can't get started.
Whoa, where do you want this?
Hey now, I ordered a new copier.
This is better than new, my friend.
Allow me to demonstrate.
Oh, what do we have here?
Wow.
Enlarges, too.
Even double A's.
I'll take it.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
That was close. I didn't think I could shove this baby through.
If you think your disposable razor shaves as comfortably as Gillette Sensor XL, try Sensor XL. We bet you don't go back to disposables. Because only Sensor XL has microfins for extra comfort.
Wow.
Take the Sensor XL challenge.
Sensor XL back.
Bet you don't go back.
I mean it.
I know.
I'm not coming back. I'm serious. It's final.
Go ahead.
Across America, more people use Cellular One than any other cellular service.
Now I get to this bridge, I'm not turning around. And I mean it.
See the dude.
Be the dude.
Whoa.
nothing's more intense than slamming a dude.
Nat's Deli is naming a sandwich after me.
This is one hero that's hard to swallow.
I think he's dead.
Are you sure? Because I've been fooled by men before.
Inc. CBS Big Company Monday.
49-41, North Carolina-Charlotte first round game for the West Regional in Tucson. Bob Carpenter with Billy Packer, 11:45 to go in the game. And some interesting things happening down the stretch here. DeMarco Johnson is one of seven today. We just saw him miss a very makeable jumper, and they've got to get him on track to hold on to this one.
They really do. You need to get some explosive scoring for a man shooting, scoring under 20 points, just under 20 points a game at a high this year at 32 against Houston. Has been no factor today. Don't expect the man who's averaging 4 points a game to carry offensively, and that's what they're doing right now in regard to Shaw. They've got to get DeMarco Johnson on track.
Victor Page, well low with the three. Last touch by Charlotte. It'll stay with the Hoyas.
Page got hit on the arm on that shot by Colson. No call. But you have a sense that the momentum is swinging here a little bit, Bob.
Yeah.
Georgetown getting much more confident. They really had a good offensive idea when Jahani White was in the game, punching everything down inside. They don't have that threat on the floor right now.
Victor Page with Ja out there helping him, trying to blow by Shanderick Downs, who got the foul.
Well, a little bit of difference here because he's not in the box at one, so he doesn't have the help he had before. Page recognizes it and goes right on by him.
And Shanderick, after getting poked in the eye and cut under the eye, wearing the butterfly. Melvin Watkins, a little nervous right now. He'd have been a lot more tense if Page had dropped that three. It stays an 8-point game.
And he is taking his time getting cool back into the ball game, who has three fouls.
That's Tuomu fouling Sean Colson.
And John Thompson comes back with Jahidi White, and you can bet that he is going to go down inside low offensively.
Well, we've got the Utes and Navy out here. Providence, Marquette in the southeast. ODU in New Mexico out of the WAC in the east. Temple and Ole Miss. Ole Miss had a great run this year in the SEC West. Jahidi White and company trying to get something going to get back in this game. And as Billy has mentioned, for Georgetown, it starts at the defensive end. Sean Colson being watched by Ed Sheffy. 45 seconds away from the midway point of the second half. On top to DeMarco Johnson. Colson trying to get the rebound was Tremaine Gardner, and it's going back the other way to Georgetown. Victor Page with the turnover, and Colson takes on Sheffy and draws the foul baseline left after Georgetown really had an unforced error there, giving the ball away at midcourt.
You know, it was interesting there watching Colson. He pretended as if he was going to pull the ball back out, realized that Georgetown had kind of gone to sleep on him, and then took off to the basket.
Ed Sheffy with his third foul. We've got a couple of key players playing with three. There's a good entry pass. DeMarco Johnson up strong, and the backdoor rebound by Tremaine Gardner of Charlotte. His second basket of the day, and the 49ers now over the Hoyas by 10.
Well, there's Gardner averaging 2.5 a game, and Shaw averaging 4 a game, and these two guys have been the offense because DeMarco Johnson has not been able to get untracked at all.
With that miss, he's now 1-for-9. Sheffy with penetration. Colson took it away. Gets it back from Shaw. And Victor Page knocks it away.
Two incredible plays on both ends of the floor. And Victor Page really did a nice job chasing this down. A nice, clean play here. You'll see him come across. Gets all ball.
Victor Page struggling offensively, but a big defensive play to avoid an easy two by Sean Colson. Herschel Shaw with a big game today. Upper left of your screen, Joseph Tuomu is the man who just came in for John Thompson.
You know, Shaw get a lot of credit when you look at the stat sheets today, but he won't get enough credit for how well he's played this game from a standpoint of his floor game. I mean, he just totally understanding what's going on.
Preston with a hesitation move, and he draws foul number 4 on Victor Page.
Second time today, Bob, we have seen him throw the ball up on the glass. Remember that layup in the first half that just kind of died on the rim? That one had reverse English on it and still goes in the basket. Here's Page coming down. Now watch the reverse English he puts on it. Up there, perfect shot. Sensational play on the way down to the floor. This young man knows how to play the game.
Pressure. That's what the Charlotte coaches say about him, and they knew he would be such a key man against the likes of that Georgetown pressure. So we've got some foul trouble mounting in this one as Charlotte with that basket goes up by a dozen with 9:28 to go. Victor Page has just drawn his fourth. Sheffy Ja and Jahidi White all three. Jahidi's came early. Shandirick Downs with 3-4. The number 7 seed, Charlotte.
And Page stays out there with 4 fouls on him, almost a little over 9 minutes to go. And I guarantee if he's matched up with Colson, Colson will be smart enough to take him with the dribble.
Colson with 13 on the day, completing the conventional three-point play. And a 13-point lead for the 49ers out of the very strong Conference USA. They tied Memphis atop the white division for the conference record of 10-4 and then won it on the tiebreaker.
Nice scouting job by UNC Charlotte against Georgetown, and the fact that that box and one is inside the foul line now. You're not supposed to give up the shot to the one man you're guarding.
Victor Page, that man, got the 3, a dozen for Victor. He's going to do some heavy offensive work and be careful with those 4 fouls.
Well, he's on Davis. See if they try to set up Davis to get him the ball and make Page guard him. Johnson with a screen. They just can't get Davis the ball.
Bubakar Al with a little reach around on Versal Shaw.
But without question, Melvin Watkins now is going to try to get Davis a touch here to see if they can't pick up that 5th foul on Victor Page.
So Bubakar Al now with his 3rd, joining a host of Hoyas with at least 3. Into the line goes Versal Shaw. He was a catamount of Western Carolina as a freshman back in 95. Went to the College of Eastern Utah for some JUCO. Just a junior, having the day of his life. Will his teammates be able to hang on and win this thing? Here's Victor Page. Nice kiss off the glass.
Well, he just forced the score right there. It really wasn't a wise play because there's nobody down there to rebound, but he is so tough.
And with plenty of time in this game remaining, Georgetown is right back in it, down by 8.
I keep saying to myself, UNC Charlotte will not win this game unless they get Johnson started offensively. But they keep hanging in there.
And now that you've said it to me, I agree with you. He has got to get something going. 4 points all in the first half as Joseph Tuomu a little off balance, and he was all over Sean Colson. Well, Tennessee Chattanooga, that big shocker today, dropping the number 3 seed Georgia in the southeast. Host of Hoyas are back in there. Sheffy's back in. That's Jahidi White taking a seat.
You know, I think back and I mentioned about UNC Charlotte going into the basketball Division I business back in 71. Bill Foster put that program together, much as he had to do when he went down and took over Miami's situation. Yeah. They've been out of basketball for a while. It wasn't exactly the same. And of course, in a very short period of time, after Bill Foster left and went down to Clemson, and Lee Rose came in there, and as I mentioned before, went to the NIT final, got beat in the NIT final by Kentucky. And then the very next year, with a 28-5 record, won the Sun Belt Championship, knocked off Central Michigan, then Syracuse, then Michigan, and then lost to Marquette on that Jerome Whitehead play.
Yeah.
Remember that one? 51-49, and then lost in a consolation game to UNLV. It was an incredible run from 71 going in Division I for the first time to 77 in the Final Four. Another touchdown.
DeMarco Johnson can't reach it, though. This pass incomplete from Sean Colson. He had him running a post pattern. He couldn't quite get it there.
Probably needed a little bit more height on that ball. Let him run under it.
A tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS.
So then Doris is driving it, and she says, but Elliot, I can't view the road. And I said, but what do you expect? It's a luxury car. Anyway, we then drive it down the road. Have you driven that?
Bored with traditional luxury? It could be time for the supercharged Bonneville, one of the world's most powerful sports sedans.
Do you drive a luxury car, Frank?
You bet your ascot I do.
Luxury with attitude. The Bonneville by Pontiac.
At Ernst & Young, we never forget that one of the most dangerous days in the life of a business is the day it reaches its goal. Because if success turns into complacency, the job a company faces may not be protecting its position, but fighting for it all over again. Ernst & Young, there isn't a business we can't improve.
Introducing the Midas No-Nonsense Brake Sale, the biggest brake sale in our history. With any regularly priced brake service over $100, you get a $40 rebate. But hurry in. $40 rebate ends March 30th.
Is your dandruff sending the wrong signals? Get Selsun Power. Doctors recommend Selsun Blue number one. So don't send the wrong signals. Get Selsun Power.
The RCA Home Theater. With SRS Sound. Is 50% brighter. With a sharper, clearer picture. Better picture, better sound. Better get out of the way. From now until April 20th, save as much as $100 by mail on select RCA products.
Well, let's summarize this one with 7:47 remaining. Georgetown has really improved its shooting since halftime. Will it be enough to come back? They've cut down their turnovers. Victor Page now has 15, still playing with those four fouls.
Well, that's really critical, and you can see that Melvin Watkins has come back with cool. He sat on that bench for quite some time, so that gives him a little bit more power down inside and not the foul trouble. He's still got three and may be able to keep some power down there to stop Jahidi White from setting up down low.
That turnover. Last touched by Andre Davis of Charlotte, so the Hoyas will keep it.
Well, you can see how Georgetown trying so hard to get that ball in Page's hands. And that defense by UNC Charlotte, which is now man-to-man, when they go into that box and one, they're really packing it down inside.
Jahidi White had to run that one home. That's his first field goal of the day. Back to an eight-point game.
But a very nice tactic by John Thompson to go down with the power game inside, get Yaya Dye to go ahead and rebound off of it and take away some of that pressure on Page.
That's Ed Sheffy's fourth.
Here we see Jahidi White backing in Alexander Cole. No call by the official there, and I think wisely so. A good soft layup. So he gets the ball inside, powers. Cole gets knocked off balance. You know, you think about this Georgetown team, everybody's thinking Allen Iverson, but you know, Othello Harrington was the 30th guy drafted last year in the NBA, and of course, Jerome Williams was also a first-round draft choice, so three big factors in the Georgetown program the last few years, no longer there.
Lane violation, DeMarco Johnson.
Well, he's not only not scoring, he's taking away baskets from his teammates now. Really having an off game for the first team all-conference performer from Conference USA.
Down to the 7-minute mark remaining. It's Charlotte by 9 over Georgetown. Conference USA against the Big East here. That's Davis, the defensive stopper with the block. But Victor Page got it right back. He does a 360, can't knock it down. And DeMarco Johnson, the strong Charlotte rebound.
Talk about some pretty good timing by Davis on that block. He wanted it. Now here's Colson on Page. Let's see if they go ahead and try to use him. I think Melvin Watkins used to be a very outstanding guard in college, and there's the switch by Georgetown. Didn't let him set it up. Nice move by both coaches.
First-year coach against a 25th-year coach here. And Watkins has been assistant for a long time, and as a head coach, he loves having a guy like Sean Colson. Little shake and bake there, and he has 17.
Well, Watkins assisted under Jeff Mullins and played under outstanding coaches like Lee Rose, who's doing a fine job now with the Charlotte Hornets, and Bill Foster, so he's been well trained.
18 years he waited for this chance. Yaya Ja with the jumper, and that's 8 for him. 5:45 remaining. 49ers over the Hoyas by 9. There's Downs. He drills the 3.
And Colson made that play by recognizing the double team trap coming at him. The best thing you can ever do is anticipate the trap, make the play before it gets there, and he did just that.
Shanderik Downs shot 49% from three-point range in conference play this year. He's got a pair of threes in this game.
And Davis chasing Page everywhere.
And Sheffy answers with his second 3 of the day.
Is that the first jump shot we've seen in what seems like the entire game from Georgetown?
5:05 remaining, and it stays a 9-point game as we're trading trays all over the place. Olsen trying to break down Damon Jackson on the dribble.
Well, Jackson has fouls to give, and he's trying to use a lot of body on Colson. Colson awful quick with that crossover.
Shot clock inside 10. There's a little push.
Jackson did a fine job the whole time moving his feet, and at the last second, when he gets it down to 9 seconds, does the hand check and gets called.
Little shot clock panic there on the part of the defender. Herschel Shaw, the story of this game for North Carolina Charlotte, is back in.
And that, Bob, is a very good point. You know, you're guarding a guy out front. You know he wants to hold it down to under the 10-second mark. The clock becomes another one of your teammates if you can get him down inside 6. So keep moving your feet. Don't reach out with the hands.
Oh, Colson way short with it, just off the front of the iron. 78% shooter. Melvin Watkins a part of most of UNC Charlotte history in terms of wins, postseason play, and another chapter here today. His team on top by 10 with 4:40 remaining. This is at Sheffy. For Ja, and he's got 2 in a row. 10 for Yaya today.
Just can't put Georgetown away.
And they're staying in it with shooting.
They're shooting over 50% in this half after shooting 29% in the first half.
Away from the trap for DeMarco Johnson. On top for Downs.
A little early to sit on the ball here. DeMarco Johnson didn't catch the ball and try to do something offensively. There's Colson.
He takes a hit.
Can you believe this?
How can you hit that shot with a guy 290 running into you?
Laying it on the arm. That's the second shot that Colson has made down the wire here. The first one with Page draped on him, and that time Jawani White hits him. Colson is on the way back down. The referee basically almost turned on it and didn't see that the shot went in. This is some shot. He's ridden about 2 feet out of the way and still makes it.
Billy, I think he took the shot as an afterthought after the aftershock of Jahidi White running into it.
Well, a pretty good rule for young kids, though, to remember. And there's the tap back to Marco Johnson.
Yep.
Nice play.
Big possession here. We move under the 4-minute mark remaining. Charlotte on top of Georgetown by 10. The winner of this game will take on the winner of our next game, which is Utah Navy, number 2 against number 15. And there's DeMarco with a basket for the first time in this half.
Well, what UNC Charlotte did well that time is go ahead and get the ball down inside when they saw the trap coming and affect their offense instead of trying to play a delay game. Good help by Shaw. There he is again. Boy, he is playing an intelligent game out here today. Big numbers, but really using his head well, too. They're going to have to trap a lot earlier. They're giving up too much time off the clock. Colson, then down to Cool. What a big-time rejection by Jahidi White there. There's Jackson taking a reach from Colson. Nice piece of sportsmanship by Colson. Realized he reached out. Jackson was in a little bit of trouble being up in the air. Then goes over and helps him up off the floor. Here's Cool. You've got to finish this off. If you're 7 feet tall, you get the perfect pass inside at least to get fouled. Good block by Jahidi White. Georgetown with 20 turnovers today. Bubakar Awa's back. Joseph Tuomu follows him as Jahidi White takes a seat. And to the line, Damon Jackson. Last year, Georgetown had a nice run in the NCAA tournament, beating Mississippi Valley, then the good win over New Mexico, then that win over Texas Tech when it looked like Texas Tech was going to really make a solid run, having beaten North Carolina, and then finally ran into John Camby, Marcus Camby and John Calipari, losing to Massachusetts.
Yeah, losing decisively 86-62.
You know, and UNC Charlotte has not won an opening round game in the last three trips to the NCAA tournament.
They're 3 minutes away.
Hey, buddy. I'll trade you my scarf for that last Bud Light.
Come on. But the hat?
That's fair.
What more could you possibly want, huh? Oh.
For the great taste that will fill you up and never let you down.
I never said it was the last one.
Make it a Bud Light.
You all wear Zoom Air. You know how responsive it is. How do you feel about wearing shoes that make you even faster? Gary, conflicting emotions?
Well, I keep telling myself I'm doing it for the team. They need me to be explosive. But sometimes that's not even enough. The hardest part is putting them on. When I'm lacing them up, I always try to think of happy things, like ice cream, or puppies,
or shrimp.
Gary, you are one sweet guy. Did everybody hear the puppy part?
Hey, what's that?
Incredible.
What?
Impossible.
What? What?
Primestar satellite dishes.
What?
Zillions of them.
Where are they coming from?
That way.
Radio Shack?
Radio Shack is America's number one retailer of Primestar digital satellite TV. Surprised? Don't be. Who knows more about satellite TV than the people at Radio Shack?
Hey, what's that?
I don't know, but I'm not putting one on my roof. Radio Shack. You've got questions, we've got answers.
Come here.
No, I'm Millie Fountain, and I have two kids, and I drive a Saturn. I decided to buy the car because it looked very sporty, and it was very inexpensive. I found that Saturn gave me the most for my money.
Uh-oh, we dropped one.
It's my first major purchase that I've ever purchased by myself. I didn't feel as though they were taking advantage of me at all. You can just drive and you can relax.
On television's highest-rated new drama, can knowing the future save a young athlete's life?
Just change it back.
I can't. It doesn't work that way.
Early edition, CBS Saturday.
Well, Charlotte's starting to sense a little bit of history here. Timeouts. Georgetown has no 20s remaining. Both coaches have their fulls. Charlotte has the possession arrow. They also have the family affair here tonight. Pharrell Watkins in black. That's Melvin's wife with daughter Kia and sons Manuel, Marcus. Family affair. They're 3 minutes away from round two and a little bit of history for this program.
I mentioned that they have lost the last three times they've been in the NCAA tournament. They've lost in the first round, but only by a total of 10 points. So some heartbreaking games for them.
Colson.
Look at that.
Shaw, very intelligent.
He is really having a great game in the head.
If the easy one's not there, take it back out with all that time on the shot clock.
How about that? That shot. 14 seconds to go on the clock, and here's Shaw is just doing everything right. Gets that one finally stolen from him, but.
Yeah, Damon Jackson, the man who knocked it away. Here comes Victor Page for Georgetown. He will drive and he will finish. And Victor with 17 on the day, 15 of those since halftime.
Bad place to throw that ball down in the far corner.
9-point game with 2:15 and counting. Straight ahead. And all the way home goes Downs, and he has 8 today, redeeming himself after that poor 3-point shot.
Yeah, you probably have to question with 14 seconds on the shot clock taking a 3.
Wow. Damon Jackson with a big-time move and a great finish drawing the foul.
We're seeing a lot of slashing moves now by Georgetown. 2 minutes to go. They're still in the hunt here. Down 9, going to the line.
Ursel Shaw with his second foul.
Good slashing move by Jackson.
Tremaine Gardner back for the 49ers out of Charlotte.
Jackson had 12 points in the semifinal game against BC in the Big East tournament this year.
That was Shenard Long who just came in. Teammate Damon Jackson trying to finish the 3-point play. This to make it an 8-point game.
And set up the press.
Helps when you've got Sean Colson back there. He just wiggles his way out of it. They're trying to trap him now, and there's some body contact by Boubacar Al. That'll be his fourth.
Colson just keeps trying to go around the arc, you know. One of these times you're going to see him change direction, go right down the middle, and be wide open.
Well, look at Coppin State with only 3:16. That would be a major 15-over-2 upset.
It's like the 14s and the 3s and the 15s and the 2s are having their problems in this tournament.
Looks like Tulsa's going to breeze into the next round in Kansas City. They went out in the first round at OT last year. There's Colson with his 21st point of the day.
We saw in the first round last night, Villanova winning, and Charles Jones, the nation's leading scorer, putting up 37 points on 37 shots. So the nation's leading scorer had the leading scoring day of anybody in the NCAA tournament.
That's Sheffy from Page. Tried to penetrate. Here comes Sean Colson for Charlotte. He was anticipating contact. Back the other way, Sheffy for Page. Victor for 3. Long with it. And it's Gardner for Charlotte with a rebound with a minute 27 remaining. DeMarco Johnson. And he's fouled from behind by Boubacar Al. And that would be his fifth.
Well, you can't fault Colson on the last one to kind of bailing out on that layup. He tried to put it up left hand. He was being chased down by Jackson and Page and a few others.
Well, Billy, Boubacar Al's going to foul out here, but when nobody else could score for Georgetown, he's the one man who kept John Thompson's team afloat offensively.
Well, I give John a lot of credit for realizing his team was in deep trouble at halftime, coming out with tough, hard-nosed man-to-man, and that helped all get started, too.
It looks like Charlotte will be moving into round two to take on the winner of Utah and Navy. That's our next game coming up here from Tucson. 1:22 to go, the 49ers by 10.
When I say facts to report to me by 5, I mean 5.
You can kiss that promotion goodbye, Shorty.
Your accountant's on line 1. The audit next Tuesday.
Your wife's on 2. And where's the dry cleaning?
Yeah, where's the dry cleaning?
Life getting a bit overwhelming? Try the simple thrill of an Accord Coupe. From Honda.
Be active, but beware. Use an ordinary stick antiperspirant, you get flaky white stuff. Until now, Gillette introduces new Clear Stick. A clear advantage against odor and wetness. New Gillette Clear Stick. Or try cool, refreshing clear gel.
Since Wendy's 5-piece chicken nuggets are just 99 cents, everyone's eating them.
What are those?
Chicken nuggets.
Since when do you order nuggets?
Since they've been 99 cents.
Oh. So what else you been keeping from me?
It's quite possibly the best deal in chicken.
5:27 now, boy.
Hey, Junior, we don't want to miss our curtain. I hope you've got Hertz number one club gold.
Well, not exactly, but this company's fast.
Oh, sure.
Can't we skip the rental counter like it hurts?
Well, not exactly.
Hey, Junior,
Tucson waterlogged. Doesn't your company have a canopy like Hertz?
Well, not exactly. Remember, there's Hertz and there's not exactly. Choose the right one.
So you still think I'm the dummy?
Not exactly.
Approximately 10, 9, give or take, somewhere in the vicinity of 8, about 7, 6 or so, 5, plus or minus, 4, I think, 3, 2-ish, 1, liftoff. Any moment now, here it comes. Still waiting.
Torn by secrets, bound by blood.
You have to show a little respect.
Mario Puzo's The Last Dawn, CBS Sunday, May 11th.
Delvin Watkins has been a part of all 5 NCAAs, all 3 NITs, and all 6 20-win seasons at North Carolina Charlotte, and they might just break that round one losing streak here today.
Pretty good shape. And I never thought that they would be able to withstand this little rush by Georgetown without DeMarco Johnson becoming a factor. He didn't. Give credit to Shaw and Colson and Downs for being able to come up big. You know, looking at Georgetown, we talked about their shooting percentage, but Bob, one of the things about this team this year, they had 102 more turnovers than assists, which is a disaster if you're not a good shooting ball club. And today they've got 21 more turnovers.
David Jackson, the strong offensive rebound. Foul before the shot. It'll come with a minute 15 remaining.
21 turnovers. And as I said, on the year, 102 more turnovers than assists. And that is very difficult to make up for unless you are either some incredible rebounding club or have a bunch of great three-point shooters.
Yeah, most clubs looking for a 2-to-1 assist-to-turnover ratio. John Thompson would be happy to have a 1-to-1.
Absolutely.
Wow. Foul on Tremaine Gardner. Damon Jackson missing the front end. Rebound, Shanderick Downs.
Well, you need the points, and you also need the ball to go in there so that you can really set up the press for the steal, and neither one took place.
You know, going into the Conference USA tournament, UNC Charlotte was 0-5 against top 50 teams in the RPI. That win against Louisville by 4 is really what put them in this tournament. They had a little icing on the cake when they knocked off UAB. They played Marquette tough in the championship game before losing to the Eagles by 8. But that Louisville game is what really got them over the hump in terms of postseason play.
Well, we've heard of South Carolina being in some trouble with Coppin State. They played South Carolina early this year. They lost to South Carolina in Charlotte and also lost to Southern Cal in a two-game tournament there.
You know, Billy, in that South Carolina game, they were up 15, and against Southern Cal, they were up 20 at the half.
And then just went south in the second half in both games.
So they did some bouncing back after the first of the year once they got into conference play to go 10-4.
And that may be one of the reasons why they didn't get a lot of respect around the country. You know, early in the season, December, the team goes down, and it takes a long while to come back.
DeMarco Johnson on the foul at the line. Yaya Ja, possibly his last few minutes as a Hoya.
Young guy who, as a senior in high school in Washington, D.C., averaged 3 points, 3 rebounds a game. So yeah, to go from that position to where he has this year, leading the Big East in the rebounding.
He knew as many languages as he scored points per game. Fluent in English, French, and one of his native tongues out of Senegal. We're in the final minute, 75-62, North Carolina Charlotte. And the reach around by Damon Jackson, his fourth. Chevrolet Most Valuable Players of this game. Is there any doubt who it is for North Carolina Charlotte? A guy named Versal is the man we honor today. He came into this game today averaging 4 points and 4 rebounds a game, and he has one of his great days ever as a 49er of UNC Charlotte. His teammate DeMarco Johnson was expected to be one of the big offensive forces today, but with Johnson not able to get it done, Versal Shaw with 19, a career high, gets it done. At the other end, as we mentioned, Boubacar Al kept the Hoyas afloat. when everybody else was sinking at the offensive end.
Well, we talk about Johnson. We're talking about a guy, 23 double-doubles, and today kind of just disappeared offensively. He was 0 for 5 in the first half and didn't turn it around here much in the second half either.
Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to assist those in financial need. Final 45 seconds. Victor Page for three. He's got it. Georgetown will let things play on for the moment. 20 for Victor Page today.
And there was a case. Colson tried to block the jump shot by Page. When he didn't get it, he ran to half court. Consequently, he wasn't back for the inbound situation. UNC Charlotte throws it away.
40 seconds to go. Charlotte by 11. Victor Page out there shuttling. Down. That's Godwin Owinji, who appears for the first time today and knocks down a three. Dominguez Bundy, he's a three-point shooter. They call him 3D. And a grab at midcourt by Shenard Long. 25.8 seconds remaining.
Windy had not made a three-pointer all year. Comes in there and just buried that one.
Yeah, with a man in his face.
Johnson picking up some points now, going to this foul line here, latter stages of this game.
Just now into double figures, half of his average. Well, Jahidi White is a junior. Victor Page is sophomore. Looks like the Hoyas will finish 20 and 10. For Charlotte, it'll be 22 and 8, and on to the second round. There's Owinji again for three. Way along with it.
That's Long keeps it alive.
Yeah, Brendan Kahn down there. Some of the folks are dying for him to knock a shot down here in the final 10 seconds. 78-67, Charlotte. Rebound, a strong one by Shanderick Downs, and a foul in the backcourt.
2.7 to go, and there's Shaw over there with Coach Watkins, recognizing what an outstanding game that young man played.
Charlotte to face either second seed Utah or 15 seed Navy. That's our next game coming up here in Tucson. Burrell Watkins and the whole family having a great time on the far side.
And how about that coach's decision to start Shaw today?
It's the decision of the tournament so far.
Pretty good move.
Victor Page came into this tournament 16 of his last 57 from the field. Got off to a slow start today. Final second, and this one is over. 79-67, and for Charlotte, it's on to the second round.